magazines, you read gourmet magazines, you read Iglina and you read Pixole. So you see all the brand Dombey and whoever it is, all these dishes, and then you will see photography. That's food photography. And of course, you have fashion photography. Fashion. And fashion is not going to close now. The shoes, bracelets, earrings, t-shirt, pantyhose, hairstyle. You understand? And of course, men and women, fashion. So when they see it, or when they sports, you want to see the pictures. When it's on a catwalk, or it's set up. Then you have landscape photography. And everybody who have a camera can take landscape, right? You see a nice sunset or a nice sea. You really want to go to the country, you see the river, the beach, the mountains, landscape photography. Then you have portrait photography. Both adult portraiture and young children. Children, you know, in festival, the categories were like youth, children photography, youth. You don't mean that children to take photographs of children, photographs of children, photographs of adults. And of course, they have underwater photography, but of course, if they don't swim, I wouldn't recommend that to you. They have aerial photography that we use when there's a hurricane or to show erosion of it, or earthquake or fire. You fly a helicopter or a small thing to take a picture, that gun. And then you have creative photography, where you use your imagination and what you see, you interpret it into a different thing. And I'll show some samples today. All this is visualized, by the way. So it's what I'm telling you, you know? And of course, you have forensic photography, police. You can join the police force as a photographer. Also the army, just like how you can join the army as a medic, or the police force as, you know, psychologist, whatever. Then you have figure study. You know, I don't want to say picture of naked people, because that's different from figure study. Figure study is taste for the dumb, showing human body, you know what I mean? Then you have horticulture, flowers, plants, trees, leaves, whatever. And then you have nature. The zoo up here, you can go up here and you can take nature, but you can do the backyard where there is a where there's a goat, or where there's a dog, or where there's a pet. You see almost categories of photography. Then you have wedding photography. Everybody knows wedding photography, right? You got a clue. You have a few of them, right? Then you have the family photographer. Like Brian Sue, they go there and take the portraits. Right? Yeah, paparazzi. But you have to be fit. You know, the self-defense, the video, the red, and like, run, jump, grab it, right? They don't have much other than you. But you have those guys abroad who risk their necks and whatever else to take pictures of whoever it is, relatives, royalty, movie star, whoever, right? Then you have glamour photography. I could go on and on, but I'm just showing you now that the visual arts, all of that is part. You guys like to go to exhibitions, painting exhibitions, because it makes sense to like visual arts. And there's a big exhibition on and go. An exhibition could be like with paintings, drawings, photographs, whatever it is. Now let me tell you, I studied in New York. I did advertising and graphic design. Advertising is not part, it includes visual arts, but advertising is more concepts. They don't teach advertising. They teach journalism and everything, but how to conquer a concept. To advertise a product, right? But graphic design takes in packaging, logos, it takes in almost anything to do with graphics, right? That's what I studied. I'm going to show you some stuff. But the visual arts also takes in industrial design. Now all of your phones, tablets, whatever it is, an industrial designer, have a design, cameras, microwave oven, stove, TV, lawnmower, pasteurizer. Those have to be designed by an industrial designer. Watches, anything that's a mechanic. Cars is a specialized era of design for the industrial designers. So when you're designing motor cars, I guess a lot of these designers become attached to a certain model. But how do you identify a motor car? Sometimes by the shape or by the logo. No, that's what we do as graphic design, the logo. So whether it is the Audi, four circles, which is different from the Olympics. Mm-hmm. The VW is a circle with a VW. The Benz is a circle with a three cross, right? Three sides star. And you get to recognize a car, whether it's a Toyota, Land Rover, Jaguar, just like how you do boot, running shoes, Nike. I spend millions of dollars just for the ticket. But you have Adidas and you have Puma and you have Reebok, you have all of them just competing. Now when you go to the supermarket and you walk down the aisle, the food aisle, every tin of sausage, bean, sardine, whatever it is, it has to be designed. And that's what I studied, right? Graphic design. How do you get somebody to pick up a box of Kellogg's? If you call it easier, because Kellogg's is the most expensive. By the way, part of my job was advertising, so I'm not even about marketing and presence. The package could have pretty. The name could have big. Kellogg's, oh yes, man, you go on Kellogg's, but when you go on Kellogg's, Kellogg's was not expensive. Right? But now you have Sunshine, and you have Lasco, and you have, oh my God, geez. But all the boxes, do take a look at the boxes. Those boxes, you have to conceptualize what do you show on the boxes, the color. So whether it is, as I said, whether you tell the people, the names that goes on these things, right? Now you in a pharmacy, it works because the pharmacy has something like a boxes like this, and like a bottles. The labels have to be designed properly, and everything has to conform with your standards and the FDA, and whatever, right? The same thing with sodas. So whether it's bigger, delicious, whatever it is, D&G, it's come to design and nobody wants to do the same. Now, I don't leave graphic design and visualism. But if you realize why you can't go now into set designs, you can go into designs for planes, you can go into fashion design, right? Anything visual, apart from paintings, that you can look at on the cell phone. Even gardening, even landscape gardening. Keep decorating. You ever see those chefs in hotels? A big block of ice comes up. And start up. And when you look, you see a mermaid. You see a dolphin. And you see, beautiful, right? It's an art. The person who decorated the cake, don't know the cake, right? No. The person who decorated the cake, made the cake look so good. It's inside that is a full of photo, right? You understand what I'm saying? But visually, the cake looks good. Sometimes I just want to eat the icing, right? Like my good cousin, Selena Wong. We've got a French, but that kind of face is a smooth one, that won't look like fun. Yeah, beautiful. And of course, when you go to press, they say, cheesecake, chocolate cake. Right? Guys, people buy them and tell them, don't go for the top and sell them and sell them. Can't think about that. But that's a visual art. What's a visual art? A pantomime or a play is when they want a backdrop. They want to know how to, you know, where it is. To show a country scene. Or whether it's a show inside of a house. And then even if you're an architect, you have to know, but then you have to work with an architect because in 10 seconds, 15 seconds, the light goes off, and by the time you look, the whole place changes. My God, how changes? You ever see? spiritual realm, another political part. That is part of the visual arts. The visual arts go into motion. So when they're doing a movie, a radio commercial, I mean a TV commercial, a video, that's a little bit different because the visual arts of, I mean the motion graphics or cinema photography, the movement. I prefer my still photography, right? Now, when you walk around here on campus, you might see national commercial one, right? I don't know national commercial. I design the logo, right? National commercial. When it just became a long time. And I also I did this long before computer came into Jamaica. I just designed it. That is going in Miami. That's my design. And that logo you see on 44 branches. Black and white. But that kind of reduced now. You see on the uniforms, you see kind of signs inside, you see kind of check leaves. Everywhere you go, I design.
And that one was hand drawn.
Huh?
It was hand drawn.
This was hand drawn.
Okay.
With rolling pen and mechanical.
Yeah.
Was here, right?
Okay.
Victoria Mutual logo, the VM. I designed that. That's what we call graphic design. JMB, I designed that in one weekend for Mrs. Joan Dong, my mother. And you know something? I'm a charge rate and I'm going to get that on my guy phones to advertise it.
Oh.
But seriously, I put the most expensive work I've done was for a bank that never lasted too long. You remember?
Oh.
And then you remember that? It is now 34. Oh. Well, after that, it became part of CMMB. Quite a quarter. But I also, I designed JMMB, I designed Hard Trust logo, the original Hard Trust logo that I have. For Aerosol, and
can.
I designed the Jamaica Stock Exchange logo, JSE, right? National Rescue Agency logo, and Quad, and Principal Jones, Cafe, right? Trees and Shields. I could go on and on and on, but I want to show you just now. This is part of the visual arts, but it's graphic arts, graphic design. I did the mold, I designed the mold for this. Stress on the concrete. I decided how high, how wide, how thick, the base, where it was going to be in the front of the atrium. I chose this spot.
Oh, zing.
Every branch of NCB I visited. Because if you know NCB, I look like Olaba, don't look like Manager, don't look like Christiana, don't look like Chapleton. So I had to go and work in tandem with the same people. And it was changing one weekend. We had four trucks going on. So I don't think I look good anymore. I did Pan Caribbean, no? Before the guy who is a new agency, you know, you have a competition. A new advertising agency to be told, and then I'm put up my logo. He doesn't know why I designed the logo, right? But, you know, this is JJ Foot Drawing. I did Eden Gardens. I put all signage on Guardian. I didn't design the Guardian logo because the original Guardian Life came from China. So just to give you an idea. Now, the visual arts portfolio is very wide. I don't touch interior decoration yet. I don't touch architecture yet. You know, I know students right now want to do architecture, but they did draw in school, they did those art classes, and have to go back to NMI to do a course. So, be able to enter UTEC, right? I mean, let me tell you something, the visual arts to me, I said the widest field. Kind of thing. You're in fashion. Yeah, the fashion that you're in today. Clothes and beautiful. What do you call yourself? So, a dancer and fashion. And another fashion. So, if you go to a dance at night, you go to some fashion, they say, my God, what is this? You know? Seriously. Then you rest at them, have a fashion, you know, different clothes, cultures. But in all of this, you have to have a sense of color, design, whatever you know, mural. Whatever you draw on paper, you have to have a sense of drawing. All of you guys here draw? Most of you draw? Or you like drawing? Alright. Basically, I did graphic design and advertising. But it's so, I saw it happen that I had a chance of studying life drawing with one of the world's greatest anatomists. And you can go on, you can go online, Byrne Hogarth, B-Y-R-N-E, Hogarth, the creator of the original Edgar Rice Burroughs Tarzan comics. Right? He was my tutor at the School of Visual Arts in New York. A great anatomy teacher. No. I had a problem in school because my painting teacher wanted me to become Munyong. Of course, when you're doing the visual arts, you have the first 2 years. The first year is foundation year. It allows you to get a feel of modeling, which is sculpture, clay. It allows you to get a feel of textiles, painting, three-dimensional wire, you know? Before you make up your mind, what I find is that in Jamaica, when I go talk like this, you go home now and all of a sudden you start to think, my God, feet is wide open. But most students I know, they want to know what they want to become before they even start to draw. I want to become myself. So we have to think of the future. Now, I heard on the radio somebody being interviewed. I think a young lady got a scholarship, right? But the scholarship goes to a final year student. She's at Maritime Institute. Now we today are here at university. I'm not going to say to you, it is too late to change. It's not too late to change, or it is too late to change. But how many of you give a serious thought of what you want to do? If you love doing what you want to do? Do you choose a career because it pays and you get good money? No. Do you choose something that sometime in the future in Jamaica, they wanna need my skills, right? Of course, rather than computer, IT, accounts, that will always be good, right? But whoever thought of maritime, with ships going here and there, the free port, you understand what I'm saying? People always say, I met a young lady there, she's in Pyramid. You used to go to the school a lot. Then I'm like, well, I wanted to join, but my parents said, honey, you went to an artist, I'm big for money, big food. Then I said, all artists poor.
Poor.
They don't make no money and all that. But let me tell you something. It takes some time. I mean, right now, if you say, oh, well, we're on the body, right? Most people know work, but I'm a multi-talented. I draw, I take photographs, I do calligraphy. I design, I do television commercials, I do logos, so I can, if something is not happening here, I can go, people call me, like last week, right now I'm doing 3 citations, major citations, by hand, calligraphy, on parchment paper, for 3 past presidents of the Jamaica Shipping Association. They're coming from abroad, and I have the 75th anniversary. Coming from England, US, all over Australia, and I'm doing citations to hand to them. The Musgrave Silver Medal, the Musgrave Medal Awards, is going to hand out next week, 22nd. I got mine in 2008. But the person who used this certificate,